Very good morning to all the children. Beta, we are going to complete this chapter today because only one page is left. Almost we have completed all the technical terms. So kindly note down the points written on the board. These points will help you to remember the chronology of events. Otherwise, it is a difficult chapter, but you note down the points, it will become quite easier for you. So very first point is, Bright got the idea for his new theory about cell life. So on the, you can say footnotes of page 36. We have already read 36 page, but the last paragraph was left. There we will be reading about how a Bright generated the idea for his new theory about cells and with whose help he continued this invention. He was having many other you can say scholars with him, other Bright students who were his friends also, class fellows also. So they will be helping a Bright. Last second boy again, it's visible what you're doing. So then next is a Bright graduated from Harvard with second position. Harvard University, one of the best universities of the world. And he scored topmost position over there. That is quite, you can say, impressive thing. Then that shows that persons, you know, people give excuses that I am doing good in my experimentation. That's why I could not get marks. But no, he was concentrating on his studies as well as he was participating in many scientific exhibitions, fairs, and other competitions. His science curiosity increased. After bagging various positions, his curiosity kept on increasing. It did not stop. There was no full stop for him. He was continuously learning. Fine? One should be a continuous learner only in life. The last point is other talents. Now in other talents, you can see I have just shown various branches. He was a champion debater. Who's a debater? A person who can put forth his point of view and convince the audience to believe in him. That person is called a debater. Fine? As well as he was a public speaker also. Public speaker is a person who knows how to voice his opinion. Clear? Debating is something else. Speaking is just giving a speech only. Clear? Whatever points I'm discussing now, Rian will be explaining to me. Fine? Next is good canoeist. Canoeist, canoe. What do you mean by canoe? Boating and all. Fine. So he used to go into the waters and good canoeist. He would use oars and all, and he can, you can say, love for the water exploration. He was into this thing. Fine. Then we have expert photographer. He loved nature and surroundings. We know since childhood he has been experimenting on butterflies, and he was collecting butterflies, monarchs, viceroys and all. So the people who are very good observers, only they can perform experiments. Fine, one has to be, this is the basic quality of, and there is one question in your book, what are the qualities to become a scientist? So a scientist has to be firstly curious enough that the person wants to generate some information. Last two boys, you're creating the disturbance to the whole class. Parikshit, you want to highlight your name on daily basis. Fine, so I was talking about that how he became a scientist. Firstly, he was having curious mind. Secondly, he got proper ground, which was, you can say, proper set was given by his mother, who kept on enhancing his knowledge, giving him practical learning and gifting him various books. So that led to more interest. So curiosity versus experiences. After gaining experiences, he also, kept on participating in various competitions. And after winning and losing also, he learned a lesson for life that one should not stop experimentation. Fine. Sooner or later, hard work pays. It never goes unrewarded. Post time lagta hai ki maine itni mehnat ki, but I could not get marks, so this is not happening. But everything, whatever efforts you are putting in now, sooner or later they will pay back to you. Fine, if you are sincere. So all these points which we will be covering, and we'll be also discussing question answers. Fine, and the ones who speak a lot in the class to disturb other students and teacher as well, they will get a chance of public speaking today. When I'll ask a question, because they love to speak. Fine, they love to speak. I'll be giving them a chance to speak here only. They will be coming and giving answers to all the questions. And the ones who are, since those who will be raising hands, those who know, they won't speak today. So let's continue. Page 36 onwards. My voice is audible to all sitting at home. Kindly send me your feedback, beta. So I'm going to share the screen. If you have noted on the points, we are on last page, beta. Last paragraph. So I'm just, while reading, I'll be finding the faces, those who will be giving answers to my questions, fine? And if you are unable to, you can leave the class immediately. Page number 36. When he saw those photos, Ibrai did not shout, "Eureka!" We were discussing what you mean by Eureka is an expression. When you have discovered something, when you have achieved something, at that time, you shout such words. Clear? So he, after even discoveries also, he did not shout like anything. He was having patience enough. Or even, he did not even utter simple words, "Yes, I have done it, I have got it." That shows that even after achieving something, he was very down to earth. But he believed that, along with his findings about insect hormones, the photos gave him the answer to one of biology's puzzles, how the cell ran. Read the blueprint of its DNA. DNA is the substance, underline, this is a question in your book also. I'm telling you answer side by side if you get a question. DNA is the substance in the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity. You might have heard this word many times in movies and all. So this is actually a structure, it's a substance in the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity of a person. It determines the form and function of the cell. Thus, DNA is the blueprint for life. Underline till this point. Clear? Now, after discovering these cells, that was the biggest discovery, but he did not respond accordingly. He did not shout to the world, "Yes, I am the person who is doing this." Ibrai and his college roommate, James R. Wong, worked all that night drawing pictures and constructing plastic models of molecules to show how it could happen. Together, they later wrote the paper that explained the theory. So these things, you require company. You require people, mentors, teachers, gurus, and intelligent co-mates also. So he was having one with him, James R. Wong, and both of them, after discovering the cells, they kept on working upon this experimentation. And n number of experiments they conducted, and finally they wrote a theory on this. Fine, now, after this beta, now enough of technical language, scientific terms. Now they're going to talk about Richard Ibrai as a student, as having different talents and other features of his life. Surprising no one who knew him, Richard Ibrai graduated from Harvard with highest honors, second in his class of 1,510. Means this is the number of students he was competing with. Out of 1,510 students, he scored, he bagged the second position. That shows how intelligent he was. Ibrai went on to become a graduate student researcher at Harvard Medical School. There he began doing experiments to test his theory. So the students who are bright enough, they get various chances also. So he became a student researcher. Have you heard of many universities are there, which are hospitals as well as they are colleges also. So professors are giving them first-hand experiences. So whenever a patient is not well, they will be, if it is a manageable circumstance, they will be calling the students and they also show them the live operations so that they get, so such sort of colleges, come universities, come hospitals, we do have. fine. Then after this beta, if the theory proves correct, it will be a big step towards understanding the processes of life. It might also lead to new ideas for preventing some types of cancer and other diseases. So now he is working upon a theory along with his friend, which can lead to, you know, cure some sorts of cancers. Cancers is of multiple types. These days, when I was a kid, we have not heard of people having cancer every now and then. But now as an adult, every day, you can say we are hearing about the people we know are having cancer. Why? Cancer generates in the body itself. These are the body cells only, which start accumulating at a particular place in the body and they become cancerous. And if it spreads, the person dies within few years only. So these, why these things are increasing? Because you should have some more knowledge out of the books also. Don't think we should read books only. Have knowledge. You will be going for medical also in plus one and plus two. Or if not, even then general knowledge should be there. That's how these things are formed. Because our, you know, daily life is so, we are into eating outside. We are into junk food. We eat, intake, sugary substance. At this point, we do not realize. We are very, you know, teenagers are very, you can say, into show off and all, that we are at this, checking in at that place, eating this and that. So once in a while, it's fine. This is my advice to all you young people, that now onwards, have good eating habits, please. This is not for anyone else. This is for you people only. Because later on in life, when you cross your 40s or 30s and all, then you people realize that, okay, I have been eating wrong since childhood and this is now affecting my health. Fine. So this is one advice from my side to you all. And now let's come back to the chapter. If the theory proves correct, it will be a big step. So he is working upon some particular theory with his friend. And he wants to do experiments in this way so that it can find some types of cancers and other diseases and how to cure it. All of this is possible because of Ebright's scientific curiosity. So his curiosity, his interest is increasing day by day. His high school research into the purpose of the spot Sona Monarch pupa eventually led him to his theory about cell life in human bodies. See, now compare. That's why the name of the chapter is Making of a Scientist. Scientist Banna, it's not a one day game. His mother has been digging deep into the childhood only, so that if the base is strong, building will be strong. So since childhood, he has experimented many things. He was into learning new things. And then finally, from monarch butterfly, monarch hormones to finally human hormones and human cells and how cancers are formed, he has switched to that level now. So we have seen his growth as a child and now as an adult also. Then after this, Richard Ebright has been interested in science since he first began collecting butterflies, but not so deeply that he has not time for other interests. He was having other interests also. Ebright became a champion debater, public speaker, and a good canoeist and all-round outdoors person. Means he was into camping, he was into going outside, visiting new places, taking new experiences. He's also an expert photographer, particularly of nature and scientific exhibits. So whenever some exhibition is going on or some natural scenes are there, he was quite attracted towards it. In high school, Richard Ebright was a straight A student. Because learning was easy, he turned a lot of his energy towards the debating and model United Nations clubs. Last voice, stand up, Parikshit. Without the second argument, kindly stand up. I'm using the word kindly for you. Continuously, you're talking. Don't want to listen to the teacher, sit at home. So in high school, he always used to grab A grades only. It was quite easy for him. He also found someone to admire, Richard A. Wirer, his social studies teacher and advisor to both clubs. Mr. Wirer was the perfect person for me. Then he opened my mind to new ideas, it writes. So there are many people in your journey. You know, when we become something, we forget the people who helped us. You are the people, then you just pass by the teachers and you do not even recognize. Even you should be thankful to a class nursery teacher. She was the one who set base for you. Fine. So I'm just saying you should be thankful to your parents who were the, you can say, mentors at home. Whosoever helped you in the journey of learning, you should be thankful to all of them. Fine. So he was quite thankful to, and but there are some people who have played very important role. So his social science teacher was there, Ibrahim, the social science teacher, who encouraged him, who praised him and provided him many ideas. So he is just missing. That's why he has mentioned his name. And that is, Richard was competitive. Now, yes, Richard would always give that extra effort, Mr. Wehrer said. What pleased me was, here was this person who put in 3 or 4 hours at night doing debate research, besides doing all his research with butterflies and his other interests. So not only butterflies all the time, as a good debater, as other talents, he was giving time to everything at the cost of his own sleep. So Richard was very competitive. Some people are very competitive. Some people do not want to participate at all. And the others, those who want to give their best shots also. Mr. Wehrer continued, but not in a bad sense, he explained. Richard was not interested in winning for winning's sake or winning to get a prize. Rather, he was winning because he wanted to do the best job he could. For the right reasons, he wants to be the best. So there are two kinds of competitive spirit. One is when we want to, you know, stop others to reach their goals. That is wrong way of competitive spirit. Hum isliye jeetna chahte hain ki mujhe usko harana hai. That is negative way of competitive spirit. The positive way of competitive spirit is when you want to win for your sake. You don't want to prove to others. You want to prove to yourself. So your best competition is your version. So next time you want to prove yourself best, and next time more you want to improve. So your competition should be with yourself first. Fine. And give your best shot. Recently, one person is in news, Neeraj Chopra. Fine. That young boy, he was into javelin throw. When he picked up javelin, he never thought what a javelin throw is. Casually, when he was into some running and all, and he met a person who was into this. And by seeing this boy, because he was very tall and all, and you know, some people who have quite having good height, good energy, and have good throw. So he just asked him that you should pick up this sport. He was not even knowing this. Clear? So I'm just telling you, one, sometimes people are not even aware of their own things. So one, and what he said in his interview, he said that firstly, when I saw the competition over there in Olympics, and I was scared that what a tough competition. He was having world ranking 5, I guess. So he thought that there are more 4 people there who are above my level and I won't be able to. Then his coach, his mentor, he said, just have fun while throwing the javelin. Just enjoy your shot. Do not bother about others, that whose rank is what. You just give your best shot. So that was it. And he thought, okay, I have to give best of my energy, best of my ability, and the rest is history in front of you all. Fine. So these are the things. And he has not become a javelin thrower in one go only. You know that. He has been practicing since many years. Clear? So, and that is one of the ingredients in the making of a scientist. So after discussing everything, after discussing how that started, that seed germinated when he was a child, when he had interest, did not have siblings, he was all alone. Rather than wasting time, he channelized himself. And his mother channelized the child properly, especially you can see. Then it kept on leading many achievements, and finally he became a scientist. In the last paragraph, we are going to discuss the ingredients of becoming a scientist. So let me tell you all those ingredients. Yes, beta. So ingredients means the way you prepare one dish, whatever we add and that dish gets ready. Similarly, in the making of a scientist, they're going to discuss, first of all, we should have first-rate mind. This is mentioned in your book itself. First-rate mind means your mind is not equipped with other things. Fine. Your first and foremost priority is your aim. Whatever you want to become a singer, doctor, engineer, whatsoever. You start now only. You start getting knowledge. We people, you know, we wait for the time when I will complete my 10th, when I will complete my plus two. Who has seen the next day even or the next moment? So you start now, whatever point you're having. So first-rate mind is required, a fresh mind. And then we have curiosity. Curiosity is interest in that particular thing. Second ingredient is curiosity. And mix in the will to win. Then you should have will or determination in simple words. You should have will means your wish, willpower. Kehte hai na iski willpower bahut zyada hai. In that way, willpower or determination. You should be determined ki nobody can stop me. If you have taken a decision, take a standby. And others are just shaking you. You just say, okay, fine. Main chhod deta hu, main nahi kar sakta. Okay, aap sahi keh rahe ho. To say you prove them wrong by putting in double effort. So next is. That's it. These ingredients they have discussed. At last, they have written, Ebright has these qualities. From the time the book, The Travels of Monarch 10, opened the world of science to him, Richard Ebright has never lost his scientific curiosity. So they have mentioned, fine, all the ingredients which helps in becoming a scientist. Now your turn to give answers. I have put a message in the morning in the WhatsApp group. You can see it when you go home, or you might have seen because I put before you came to school. So these two messages are for you all. Your internal assessment, I'm going to start that process now. So you have three internal assessments. Let me clarify for that. My voice is clear, beta, to all of you. Dhyan se sunna sabne. Children sitting at home, is it audible? So kindly listen carefully before doing question answers. Three types of assessments we will be doing. Number one, your notebook assessment. I have already circulated the schedule that who will be sending notebooks. So for the final checking, those who have sent, fine, they will there is no need to send it again. Clear? If you have done making of a scientist, well and good. If you have not done, even then, I won't be considering this chapter for assessment. Clear? That's why I started from today onwards. So making of a scientist is not mandatory for this term because this chapter belongs to next term. Fine. So your last chapter was Footprints Without Feet. That should be the last chapter, and grammar and writing skills, whatever we have completed. Fine. That complete work, you will get complete marks with good presentation if you have done. Anything incompleted, then do not expect that why marks are deducted. Number one. Second internal assessment is ASL, assessment of speaking and listening skills. Fine. In speaking skills, already we asked you to send a video. During the holidays, we have given you that project, and many of students made beautiful videos with proper pronunciation, with background even, and marvelously they have sent. So full marks for those who have put in efforts for speaking skills are assessed through that. Clear? You have already given that. But there are some students who have not submitted their any video to us. Still, we kept on asking, we kept on sending you messages. If you have not sent, because we will be assessing, we have the record of everything. Fine. So accordingly, marks will be given. Last chance to those who have not submitted. By 15th August, you need to send it to me. clear, need not make a 5-6 minute video. It can be up to 1 to 1.5 minute video only, fine, or 2 minutes maximum, not more than that. And third thing is listening assessment. Now, how listening will be done? Let me clarify for that also. I will be making you listen a podcast. Now, what is a podcast? Podcast is a, you can say, it can be a video or audio. It's an audio only, basically. I will be playing an audio in the class itself. I'll be giving you sheets. Those who come to school, fine. And after listening to that, it is a proper practical paper. Don't take it casually. The way your science practicals are there. In that way only, you will be appearing. Before your exam starts, there will be a particular date we will be circulating in the group. So you will be listening to that once or twice, and then you will be having the sheets with you. You will perform the way you have done earlier also. Clear? So speaking assessment, you have to send video. This is compulsory. And one more project they have added. CBSE has added one more project that I will be putting the detailed message. We will be giving you one topic. And on that topic, you have to prepare one file. Fine, proper introduction of the topic and discussion. I'll be doing it about the topic and all. So that is beta for term one of CBSE. So we will be giving you enough time for that. That will be like today we have like 12th August. So we'll be getting you 1 month exactly for that. Fine. So because that assignment is of 800 to 1000 words. That's why 800 to 1000 words means it can be up to 3-4 pages or up to 5 pages. When you write 150 words or 200 words article, it takes your 1 to 1.5 page. Fine. If you'll be writing for 800 words, more than 5 pages will be required in a file. So the whole process, bibliography and all, everything I'll be telling you in detail in the group itself. So three projects, is it clear? Notebook assessment, ASL, and one file you will be maintaining. That file, we will be giving you 1 month. But for this notebook, I'm not giving you. Yes, Chahat, what is your question? Last is just a file you need to maintain. We will be giving you the topic and we will be circulating the instructions in the WhatsApp group for that. Fine. So you need not worry that you have to cover in 1 month only. By, I guess, end of September, you can submit. Clear? So, footprints wala to then send only that. Yes. Beta, yes, this chapter is not mandatory. Rest all the chapters should be included. So let's start with the question answers now. Page number 34. Is it clear to all of you, children sitting at home, beta? The assessment criteria? Fine. So these are the questions which we are going to do now. What lesson? Page number 34. First question. Bella is gone. So we'll be continuing tomorrow. Okay.